speaker tonight. He is doing his, working on the competent communication manual, speech number 6. What is the speech number 6 goal?
Vocal variety.
Vocal variety, thank you. Title of the speech is The Importance of Listening. Peter Kingsley.
Can you all hear me?
Yes.
Can you all hear me?
Yeah.
Yes.
Can you hear that?
Yes.
Fantastic. If a tree falls in the forest and there's no one to hear, does it make a sound?
Yes.
The scientific version is, if a tree does fall in the forest, it creates waves. For if there's not an ear to hear it, then there's no sound. So my question is, whenever you're communicating or speaking with anybody, whether you're making a comment, a view or an idea, you don't have to shout. Just have to listen. Where if there's no ears to listen, is that good communications? It's got me thinking. Many years ago, I was a supervisor for an IT company, and I knew the director very, very well through sports, through our sporting interests. One day, he called me into the office. Now, I knew Stuart's name. That's what I just said. He's very loud, you could hear his feet, he would walk down the corridor. And he used to do this when he used to come into the computer room. So a lot of guys knew what was coming. So he called me to the office, he says, Peter, I want your opinion. Why is it that the other two shifts aren't performing the way your shift is performing? I said, well, what it is, and I said, I did speak to them. And they believe that everything's okay. And he ranted and raved and he screamed and oh, he just let everything go. But I sat there. I didn't respond. And he went on for about 5 or 10 minutes, just, you know, wanting to give his opinion. And all of a sudden, he sat back in his chair. And his shoulders just relaxed. That was my way now to speak. Because I listened. The three important things of doing something like that and listening is that first of all, is you get an opinion from that person. You get their views, you understand where they're coming from. It helps build rapport. And also, that other person will be more tuned in to listen to you. So, how do we listen? There's two types of ways that we listen. We listen ordinarily. So if I was in a conversation with yourself about whatever it is, sales or whatever it is, you're listening, but you're probably also saying, do I agree? Do I not agree? What's my views? What's my opinion? So we're listening, but it's just an ordinary type of listening. But there's a genuine way of listening. And that is, you listen to the person. Listen to them. See yourself in their shoes. Hear what they've got to say. Feel what they've got to feel. That is the way of listening. So, why is it so hard for people not to do that? Why can't we listen genuinely instead of ordinary? Because there's so much noise around in our own minds. We've got telephones, we've got texts, we've got emails, it's all in there all the time. So it's very difficult for us sometimes to genuinely just listen. So what's the solution? The solution is that whenever you find yourself in a situation where you need to listen, take a bit of time to step back and relax and listen to your own mind. What is it saying that particular time? What is it doing? But then sit back and relax. and you'll find that you'll be able to understand what's going on around you. So my thoughts are this. Next time you're in a conversation with somebody, just try it out. Just sit back. Listen to them. Get to know them. Feel what they're feeling. Listen to what they're listening. And then you'll find, in a lot of conversations, you'll get better results. Does that make sense?
Yes.
So it's just about listening. Quieting things down. But we have to teach ourselves to do that every single day. Just teach yourself to listen to somebody. And if you find it's difficult and you can't, just take a step back. Listen to what's going on in your head. And when you pick up that skill, you'll find that a lot of your communications, a lot of your skills will just grow and grow. And when you're having, when you're in a sales environment and you take on that role, you'll just be amazed. Because negotiations isn't about talking, it's about listening, isn't it? And we want to sell a product or a service, and we want to get it out there, we want to get to them as quick as we can, we want to hook them in there. But if we're just a little bit patient and hold back, and let their minds relax, and you can get inside their minds then, and you're communicating, it's easy. Because most sales, or most negotiations, people want to feel good. Like a car dealership, when you go to buy a car, you're already on a high anyway, aren't you? You're like, oh, you're up there, it's like, it's all emotional stuff. So all you need to do is listen to them. Observe what colours they've got, what shapes they've got. And in your conversations, just talk and bring those into it. You just got to listen. So my final thought is, again, next time you're in a conversation, just listen to that person. Put yourself in their shoes. Because that is important for their listening. Thank you.